Welcome to worship in the Unitarian Universalist Church of Charlotte. Just another church doing Lady Gaga today. Episcopal priest and theologian Matthew Fox challenges Orthodox Christian thinking with his notion of original blessing. We are born, Fox asserts, not as fallen creatures in need of redemption, but as reflections of nature's creation's goodness. You are, I am, we all are blessings. Say it if you will. I am a blessing. Say it again. I am a blessing.
I am a blessing.
Because I was born that way.
Because I was born that way.
Today we sing that assertion. Sing out our clarity that each her, each him, each they, each one of us sailing on this big green sphere, however we were born across a broad gender spectrum, each one of us is a blessing for all of us, and especially for those made most vulnerable by any who curse those who are in fact blessings. Today we are singing for our lives and for theirs.
Thank you.
We draw together again and set at our center the flickering flame of our chalice, sacred symbol of our liberating religion. In its light, may we see more clearly, understand more fully, commit more deeply to a faith rooted in freedom. Our first reading is by my Unitarian Universalist colleague, Alicia Ford. She writes, "When we pause to remember who we are, companions on this great experiment called life, when we take a moment to shed the ways we have been carefully taught to lead from fear, to persecute those who don't look like we do, to deny rights to those who love, to believe that we are separate, that some people are superior to others. When we take a moment to shed all of that, and hear our stories, hear and see each other into existence, into community. When we take a moment to embrace, to practice a different way of being, when we answer the call of love, then we are living into the promise of building the world we dream about. It is beautiful to dream, to cast a vision, to journey together, seeking to be transformed even as we transform. Seeking to be transformed even as we transform. In this spirit we commit. In this spirit we gather. In this spirit, we pray."
We have cleared off the table, the leftovers saved. Wash the dishes and put them away. I have told you a story and tucked you in tight at the end of your knockabout day. As the moon sets its sails to carry you to sleep over the midnight sea, I will sing you a song no one sang to me. May it keep you good company. You can be anybody you want to be. You can love whomever you will. You can travel any country where your heart leads, and know I will love you still. You can live by yourself, you can gather friends around, you can choose one special one. And the only measure of your words and your deeds will be the love you leave behind when you're done. There are girls who grow up strong and bold. There are boys quiet and kind. Some race on ahead, some follow behind. Some go in their own way and time. Some women love women, some men love men. Some raise children, some never do. You can dream all the day, never reaching the end of everything possible for you. Don't be rattled by names, by taunts, by games, but seek out spirits true. If you give your friends the best part of yourself, they will give the same back to you. You can be anybody you want to be. You can love whomever you will. You can travel any country where your heart leads, and know I will love you still. You can live by yourself, you can gather friends around, you can choose one special one. And the only measure of your words and your deeds will be the love you leave behind when you're done. Yes, the only measure of your words and your deeds will be the love you leave behind when you're done.
the sad eyes. Don't be discouraged, oh, I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all, and the darkness there inside you makes you feel so small. But I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors. Your true colors are beautiful like a rainbow.
Spoken word artist and poet Cenk Hoysen is done a powerful TED Talk. Anyone seen Shane Kwasin's TED Talk? I highly recommend that you take a little time. The name is in the order, Shane Kwasin, and watch his TED Talk. This reading is a tiny little snippet from about 12 minutes that Shane Kwasin does in his talk. I'm not the only kid who grew up this way, surrounded by people who used to say that rhyme about sticks and stones, as if broken bones hurt more than the names we got called. And we got called them all. So we grew up believing no one would ever fall in love with us, that we'd be lonely forever, that we'd never meet someone to make us feel like the sun was something they built for us in their tool shed. So broken heartstrings bled the blues as we tried to empty ourselves so we would feel nothing. Don't tell me that hurts less than a broken bone, that an ingrown life is something surgeons can cut away, that there's no way for it to metastasize. It does.
Dark is the night when you're feeling all alone. Weak is the light when you're feeling
I was a full-grown adult in my early 30s before I ever tasted Ethiopian food at an Ethiopian restaurant in Oakland, California. Before long, I was walking to the end of the block in the Gulfton neighborhood in Houston, where I worked two or three times a week, to gorge on spicy vegetables folded into small bites of that wonderful, spongy, sour injera. That it took me that long to experience what is now one of my favorite foods is not because there were no Ethiopians until then. Nor that those Ethiopians weren't preparing and serving food. It simply hadn't been a part of my experience until then. I was an adolescent before I knew that it was possible for someone to feel a deep disconnect between the gender assigned to them at birth and the person they knew themselves to be. I was a young adult before I ever actually knew a trans person personally. And well into adulthood before I even began to understand that gender is not either or, this or that, F or M, but is a broad and complex and fluid spectrum. As with my acquired taste for Ethiopian food, this was not because before that, the world had no trans people. Nor because a once true gender binary suddenly stopped being true. out and mostly in one closet and another, trans folks have been around. I just wasn't aware. When our city finally passed a non-discrimination clause, offering some measure of dignity to those who do not conform to some simplistic binary, I was there to celebrate. To celebrate something for which I had been an outspoken advocate. When our state responded with the absurd fraud of HB2, dreamed up by a local politician with a uniquely conservative capacity for cruelty, I spoke up. When our city capitulated, when our city lost its backbone and gave in, I hosted a tense conversation down in my office with local trans activists and the then mayor, who had agreed to withdraw that ordinance. I wasn't involved and invested as some political act. It wasn't ultimately even about social justice. You see, I believe in a certain spiritual principle. It's one that grounds my religious worldview. It's one that shapes my faith. It's something called the inherent worth and dignity of all people. That's who I am. That's who we are. That's why we offer a service like today's service. We are a liberating religion, deeply determined that all of God's children deserve dignity. We are who we are, and who we are, and what we hold dear. The vision that guides us now, it matters more than ever in a world that is far too often a place of ridicule, cruelty, exclusion, discrimination. We endeavor to embody our ambitious principles, not for some anonymous thems. We name and then reach for our lofty vision, for ourselves, for our children, for our own members, for any and for all who have ever heard a message that invokes anxiety, self-doubt, insecurity, or fear. At whatever point in our individual experience we came to understand, or we are coming to understand, the realities and complexities of gender, today we collectively say and we sing our awareness, our message. We see you. We hear you. We honor and we love you. We are committed to being co-conspirators with you in creating a transformed world. I invite us into a time of meditation. Oh dear, dear, beautiful people. Each time you are broken, we break. Each time any of us is broken, we all break. But together, in compassion, but with fierce tenacity, we are all being pieced back together, resurrecting, becoming more luminous, more loving toward ourselves and others. My beautiful people, our dangerous sweetness is our rebellion. Welcome to today's service. We're honored to have guests with us. Our members would like to greet you following the service so that they might do so. If you are visiting, please raise your hand and keep it up. While their hands are still up, members, take a look around. Notice our guests seated near you. After the service, invite them to join you for coffee and conversation in Freeman Hall. Should it enhance your experience of future services, you can find both a large print order of service and a personal hearing assistance device on the table at the entrance to the sanctuary. If you'd like to learn more about us, please fill out a yellow card and place your completed card in an offering basket when it's passed in just a moment. Members with a life event to share can do so on the reverse side of the card. You'll find them along with offering envelopes in the clipboards at the end of your row. Please begin passing those clipboards down your row now. Some returning visitors may be interested in hearing about how to become a member. If so, talk with our membership coordinator, Kelly Green. Her contact information is on the back of your order. Again, to each of you, welcome. Following the service today, you have choices. You might decide to stick around and engage in a snacking Sunday conversation with our youth in Freeman Hall. You might decide to meet the group downstairs in the vestibule at 12:45 that is going to lunch together. You might decide to snack and then move outside with our gardening group that will be working on our grounds this afternoon. Please take advantage of these opportunities and find your way into deeper connection here in this congregation. So I hope by now it's not a very well-kept secret that next Sunday we will welcome our new minister, Eve Stevens. Now, someone said to me before this service, "So I hear you're leaving." So I offer you either relief or disappointment. Or both. That so far as I know, the board has not explained to me that I'm going anywhere. I'm certainly hoping that's the case, because I have longed and looked forward to the day when I could share ministry here with a colleague. And I look forward to welcoming Eve Stevens into the life of this congregation with you. So that we might do so, there's a poster board in Freeman Hall. We're inviting you to sign a message to Eve upon her arrival. When she gets here, this board will be in her office. So if you haven't had a chance to do so already, drop a note to Eve. Also on next Sunday, one of the most significant events in the life of this congregation, on Sunday evening, we will culminate a year-long coming-of-age program for our adolescents, their mentors, and our families, by gathering in this space on Sunday evening to hear adolescents in this congregation offer their personal credos to those of us who will come and hear them. I urge you, please, consider seriously coming back on Sunday evening. I assure you that you will not regret doing so. It is generosity that makes all of this possible. It's generosity that assures our continuance. We who are the givers are the most blessed of recipients. So now we will both give and receive our offering. Thank you. don't need to tell you that people can be cruel. People can be hateful. People can be so combative. Not a single person in this room that won't benefit from being affirmed. So turn to somebody next to you and say, "You are a blessing." Now turn to somebody else and tell them, "You are a blessing." Now, tell one more person. Tell one more person, "You were born that way."
Please join us.